Hello, beautiful friends. It's Erica, and welcome to part four of my six-part series titled Mars and Venus, The Lover's Dance. This is a series I've been doing this spring, highlighting basically a five-month period where Mars and Venus are doing a very beautiful dance. They've been hanging out in some of the same signs since early March, actually end of March, technically. If you haven't seen the first three parts of this series, I definitely recommend watching them sequentially because it's really quite beautiful how this dance is emerging. And I was really feeling strongly. It's almost like Mars and Venus prior to this video. It's like they've been circling each other for a while. They've kind of been in the vicinity. And now they're actually going to start to do a little bit of this actual kind of Venus is a little ahead of Mars and then he joins her. And so there's a little bit more interaction, I believe, that's on its way for the next few videos. So this video is going to cover the time period of when Venus enters Aries, which she did on May 2nd, while Mars is still hanging out in the energy of Pisces through May 24th. So we're kind of going to cover pretty much most of the month of May while she's in Aries and he's still in Pisces. Now, parts five and six. Part five, I think, is going to be fascinating because it's going to be the 4 days that both Mars and Venus are in the sign of Aries. And I, quite frankly, have this feeling that that's going to be pretty electric. And then part six will be what happens when Venus goes into Taurus on May 28th and Mars is still hanging out in Aries, which is his home sign in terms of where he's very much expressing the fullness of his energy. So you guys can see why this beautiful lover's dance storyline is just taking shape so beautifully. So we're going to pull some cards and get some overall energies here for Mars and Venus during this time frame. Now, I want to quickly have a quick announcement here. I know you guys, if you watch my videos, you've seen just the last couple I've posted. I am testing out a new platform for delivering my extendeds. And so far, the response has been overwhelmingly extremely positive, super easy to use, really. You have the option to rent versus purchase for a little bit less money. Like, there's just all sorts of new functionality that I think is really good. But I do have to say, I did get one person commenting to me how they were charged a little bit of sales tax. And I am looking into that. I don't know what's causing that. And so if you would, I also know other people have not been charged. So there's only so much I can test on my end. So I really rely on your guys' feedback to me on whether I'm trying to figure out if it's how many people are affected by this, understanding maybe if it's a country specific thing, because I know there are some international laws around some taxes from different countries for digital products. So anyway, I'm figuring it out. So bear with me, please. But I do really rely on your feedback. So if you have anything to share or want to share, like where you're from, if you're using PayPal or if you're using a credit card, reply to the email that's on your receipt. And I would welcome all the feedback as I start to decide if I'm going to continue to use this platform, if I'm going to go back to the one I've been using, or if I'm going to find a third one altogether, a different one. So just bear with me as I'm trying to make this a better experience for all of you. And I appreciate the feedback I have been getting. You guys are amazing. Okay, so let's get started. So let's look at the energy of Mars when he is, this is from the time period, what's Mars's energy towards, overall energy towards Venus when she has moved into Aries and he's still hanging out in Pisces. he's holding himself back because she's pretty much on fuego. Wow, yeah. And he's also feeling fiercely protective of her. There's something about almost like this feeling of nobody's gonna mess with my Venus. And she's very powerful, I'm feeling. At this time when she's in the sign of Aries, but let's actually get her energy. What is Venus's energy when she is in Aries and Mars is in? Okay. The action card in the reverse. Interesting. I'm gonna get a card for the energies between both of them. Like, what's their shared energy when she's in Aries and he's still in Pisces? She's like, come get me. I was kind of getting this feeling with this card, a little bit of just like, I'm gonna just sit here and wait for you to make a move, Mars. Because she's aware that he's around her. She's putting up the sign. She's holding up her heart, saying, look it, I'm here and available. Are you going to come towards me and notice my heart that I'm willing to offer you? So she's not going to chase Mars. Even though she's in Aries, which is very fiery, she's turning that energy inward and radiating it out to Mars. And he's just like, my guides are like, boing. Like, he's feeling it. He is definitely feeling it. It's like, he's all of a sudden really taken notice of her. Not that he wasn't taking notice of her before, but it's almost like he's looking at her in this, he's feeling her energy change and he's like, what in the, like, oh my gosh, this is getting, this is already shaping up to be a pretty, like, I can feel, you guys can probably feel it too, but it's like he's looking at her as in, he's just he she was in his sights before and he was desiring her before and he was feeling his emotions before, but now all of a sudden she's captured his attention in a new way where it's like, dang girl, you are fine. Not only are you fine, but you are something I cannot resist. So okay, we're gonna here he is holding a heart. At the bottom, I mean, I'll just leave that there. I wasn't gonna use this deck anymore, but he's literally like, he's like, hey baby. How you doing? See my heart here. I have a heart too. Oh my God, you guys, this is, I mean, I am, okay. You guys know my guides are, can't make this stuff up if you tried. This is why I love Oracle cards so much, guys. I can channel energies and messages without using cards, but they are so fun to me. And you guys know I geek out on cards. I love them. I have so many, and they just speak to me. And which is why I'm also in the process still of developing. I've four different decks in the works here. Two of them have been done for about a year in terms of like. Anyway, I digress. I'm trying to break the tension because it's so. I'm like trying to distract myself from this. I feel like I'm intruding by doing this reading on these two because it's almost like I shouldn't be here observing this energy. But he's sitting down. See, he's also not quite in action. Because he's sitting down, but he's got a heart here, he's got a heart here, and he's like, hey, how you doing? She's like, I'm over here. She's pretending not to see him, but she knows he's there. But she's trying not to engage him because it's almost like he wants her to see him, and she's sort of like, oh, I'm not gonna make it that easy for you, Mars. Mars, you're not just a sit back kind of a guy. If you want me, come and get me. Like, it's pretty straightforward, but she's definitely holding up the sign and he is definitely taking notice. So I'm gonna get some tarot here. A little afraid to, because I'm not afraid to, but there's only so much I can say on YouTube. That's appropriate. Now I'm like really nervous to do part five. It's like I might just have to skip that part because that's really where I think I need to leave. I really need to leave the room and let these two do what they're gonna do. Okay. I don't even have a message yet, but here's the Knight of Pentacles. I'm gonna put him back in the deck because I was gonna share what these cards were about, but I feel like this is the masculine, ready to approach, a little bit, like a little bit. He's definitely sincere about coming forward towards the feminine. He's not moving super quickly. There is a feeling he has of, see how this horse is kind of paused? He's kind of sitting down. Let me see. Can you guys see that? Okay, you can see it. All right, I wasn't sure. The camera angle. He's ready. He's ready. It's just, I feel like he's just trying to beautify himself a little bit, trying to make himself look really good. But deep down, there's this Knight of Pentacles. So I'm going to put this back in the deck here. Let me see the Fool and the Three of Wands. Yeah, it's like he's again, he's on the brink, but he's very much hoping the feminine sees him. So what is, let's see what's he's thinking of and what he's feeling specific about the feminine when she's in Pisces. Okay. Queen of Cups, Seven of Wands, Six of Cups. See, he's got her on his mind. The woman holding a heart, the cups, the Queen of Cups. What's in his heart? What's he feeling? Whoa, that's a lot of cards. See the High Priestess there? Kind of a mystery. All right, interesting. See how he's kind of like, he's wanting her to see he's here, but there is something within him that is a little bit fearful of Eight of Cups. It's almost as though he's no matter what's going on in his physical world, his emotions are with her. His emotions, his attention, his passion is with her. But he's very much aware of his emotions for Venus, how he feels, how he sees her. And remember, Mars and Venus represent the different ways that we relate in relationships. They're the planets that are most relate to how we express in relationships, not just romantic, but relationships in general. Mars representing the masculine aspect, and Venus representing the feminine aspect of relationships. So, in the extended, I'm going to break down more in detail how they, the aspects of Mars energy versus Venus's energy specific to when they're in this dynamic. But it's almost as though, again, see, there's a lot of cups here. In fact, I'm getting drawn to the fact that there's cups, 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 cups. So the four corners of this spread are emotions, and in the middle is the tension of the wands and the five of pentacles. So it's this is what I'm saying when I say he's kind of holding himself back from Venus here. Let's actually add to this. He could be worried that it's like, when you realize when Mars realizes the depth of his emotions, the feelings he has for Venus, it brings up within him this immense feeling of fear of, like it brings up the lack of worthiness, it brings up the shame or remorse from anything from the past. And there's a feeling here that very much knows of his emotion for her, knows of his care and his love for her. Yet there's something about him that's holding back because inside he's making a transition here. He may regret if he had pulled away his energy from her and now is feeling unworthy, isn't sure if she will receive his heart if she's open to his heart anymore. He himself may be moving on from something emotionally in order to unite with her, and he may be wanting her to notice that his heart is with her, even if his circumstances may be restricting him a little bit. But let's actually add to this. Why is the Seven of Wands in Mars's space, the High Priestess? See, that's why she was showing herself before. She's a mystery. She's an enigma wrapped in a riddle. And he's keeping himself a little bit mysterious, right? He's not quite revealing everything, but he's feeling it. Remember, Pisces is water. Emotions, love, romance. I mean, the energy of romantic partnership. Now, why is the Six of Cups? Actually, before I keep going on Mars, I'm going to bring Venus into this, and then we're going to go a little bit more interesting. The Lovers is at the bottom of this deck. And the Tower. Let's see here. What's going on in Venus's mind here? Queen of Pentacles, Two of Wands, the Magician. She's feeling Nine of Pentacles with the Page of Pentacles. Ace of Swords. She wants him to ask her to dance. It's this, we're talking about the lover's dance, right? Where she's really at when she's in Aries is there is an understanding that there's a choice to be made. That she has choice here. She is realizing that her choice is in wanting to be chosen. She wants to be chosen. She wants him out of all the women in the dance hall to choose her out of everyone else. It's like she's feeling this energy of look at her. She's even beautiful here in her dress. She's ready to go. She's single and ready to, wanting to be chosen. She's wanting him to ask her to dance. to say something, to make a move, to make an initial move. And to, and she doesn't want any, she wants direct communication. It's like her heart knows that, her choice is she desires to be chosen by Mars. And if Mars, it's like she knows in her energy field, she knows in her heart that he is choosing her. She's simply waiting for the announcement. It's like she can feel him around. She's putting out the signal. And now she's simply in a place of, at some point, he's going to ask me to dance. And in the meantime, I'm happy, I'm successful. Why does she have Seven of Swords in her heart? It's like she, I feel like it's almost as though her heart knows the truth. And at the same time, is she's trusting her heart. It's so fast. Okay, let's get a card on the Seven of Swords. Why does she have the Seven of Swords? Yep, she knows. There's something here where she's waiting. She's not waiting, because she's not waiting for anything. She's enjoying herself at the party all by herself. If Mars does not ask her to dance, she's fine. But she knows he's going to. She knows he's going to choose her. And in the meantime, it's almost like she's aware of her magnetism. Why does she have the Two of Wands here? Justice. Yeah, she knows it's her turn. Everyone else in the village has partnered up. It's her time now. And she's feeling a sense of balance. At whatever she's choosing in her life, she knows she has what it takes. She knows the universe is going to manifest things. She knows that it's on its way. She can see the signs. She's looking at the stars. She's listening to her intuition. She's saying it's about to occur. Let's get a little bit more on Mars here. Why does he have the Five of Pentacles? Mm-hmm. He's going for it. He's going to go for it. But he's also in the process possibly of making some changes in his physical world. But it's almost like he's going to put on a really strong, courageous... He's got the Strength card here. While he's nervous, she might reject him here. He doesn't want to miss this opportunity. He's moving. It's like he knows he's at this incredible ball with this beautiful Venus. And he doesn't want to miss his chance. He knows he doesn't want to miss his chance. No matter what butterflies he has in his stomach, whatever, you know, things he's saying to himself in his, from his inner voice of like, you're not worthy of that, of her, or she's probably not going to be interested, but he's like, I don't care. I'm going to go for it anyway. Yeah, I'm going to go for it anyway. Chariot. Hello. In his heart space, Chariot, Knight of Wands. He does not want to miss the chance to be with Venus. Six of Cups, Three of Cups. He wants to ask her to dance. He wants to ask her out. He knows he has emotions for her. He's ready for some fun. He's ready to have a party with the divine, with Venus, who represents divine feminine. So what is, why does she have the Queen of Pentacles here? The Hanged Man. Yeah, it's like she's so aware that he's having massive, but she knows he's there. She's not sitting around her whole life, you know, holding up this big, heavy heart every day of her life, hoping someone sees it. Oh, no. She's adorned herself and brought herself out very beautifully to hold up this one big heart because she knows it's like the time to send the signal. She's not sitting there like this permanently. She's aware that the masculine has been watching and circling, that Mars has been sort of like connecting to her heart, and now she's like, show me. I know you have feelings for me. I know that you care about me. I would like, and now I'm showing you that I am open to receiving an offer. I'm open to receiving your invite to dance. I'm open. I'm showing you. Yet it's important that Mars shows up as Mars. And why does she have the Ace of Swords in the heart space? Two of Pentacles. Yep, again, she knows that she wants to be chosen. And she wants it to be clear that she's been chosen. She doesn't want any wishy-washy. Well, like maybe sorta, might she maybe a little bit wanna maybe I don't know, dance a bit. I don't know. She doesn't want that. She wants clear, forthright truth. Communication and confidence. And looks like this is what she's sending out to Mars. So, yeah, it's like, yeah, the next video will be interesting. The part five, which I haven't recorded yet, I'm doing them in order, but it's quite beautiful to watch this storyline develop. In the way that it is, it's quite delicious actually. So, before I go over to the extended to go more in depth into Mars and Venus aspects here at this period, I'm going to leave you with a guidance message for each. For those of you not going to the extended, what is the best guidance for Mars when he's in Pisces and she is in Aries. What is the guidance? We get compatibility. So this is, it's like there's nothing in the world that feels better than being independent, doing your thing, but finding that person that is just made for you, that is your counterpart, that is your person. That it just feels simple with. There's laughter, there's fun. You guys are, I mean, they're each exactly wearing the same outfit. They're on the same, mat on the birds. They're throwing hearts at each other. It's like that feeling, he knows she's his, that they each know. He, Ma, Venus, sorry, Mars is clear. The universe has made Venus for him. So let's get guidance card for Venus. And she's in Aries. What's the best guidance for Venus? Resolving conflict. Again. Keeping her heart open with love, empathy, compassion, understanding, and knowing that this energy has reached the heart of the masculine. If there is something that is in between the conflict here. And it's interesting because this was the guidance message for the part three for Venus as well. Keep your heart open. See, she's got her heart open now. It's visible. Not only is he feeling it, but this is the next stage of resolving any conflict here between the two. So keep open. Know that energetically, the open heart of Venus is what can heal the world. So, my friends, I hope this was helpful. Do give it a thumbs up if this video has supported you, and I'll see some of you in the extended. Until next time, bye.